Prince William has spoken publicly for the first time since the fallout over his wife's edited family photo. It follows one global photographic agency placing the palace on the same blacklist as North Korea and Iran.
It's business as usual.
Good morning, you guys.
That was the message as Prince William visited a youth centre in West London, trying to rebound after a chaotic few days. The Princess of Wales, still recuperating from abdominal surgery, wasn't there, but she got a mention.
I'm very impressed by your artistry.
No, it's really not that impressive work. My wife is the artist.
The backlash to the revelation this Mother's Day photo was digitally manipulated by Kate continues. Global photographic agency AFP now changing its policy.
You said that Kensington Palace was a trusted source for you at the AFP. Is it still a trusted source?
No, absolutely not. Like with anything, when you're let down by a source, the bar is raised.
The palace now joins North Korea and Iran on AFP's blacklist. But the editor of Britain's top-selling newspaper says enough is enough.
I spoke to Kensington Palace that morning and said, look, how is she? And they said she's really upset and sad that she's caused all this trouble.
After the youth centre, the prince's next stop was a night honouring young people in his mother's name, the Diana Awards. He and his brother, the main speakers.
While their mother's charity is certainly a common cause for William and Harry, you couldn't say it's exactly united them. While they're both appearing at this event, it's very much in a separate capacity.
William in person speaking of his mother's inspiration.
Everyone indeed deserves a supporting hand in life. That legacy is something that both Catherine and I sought to focus on through our work.
Then Harry via video link from the US. But by arrangement, he only spoke after his brother had left. While also not at the black tie event, Harry's wife Meghan was in a ball gown as she launched her lifestyle brand, American Riviera Orchid. Sussexes also said to be cooking up another Netflix project. In London, Brett McLeod, Nine News.